In today's class, we are going to discuss the digestion of carbohydrates. In first class, I have mentioned the food that contains the lipids, carbohydrates, proteins, fibers, and etc. So, in this class, we are going to discuss the digestion of carbohydrates. Before going to see how digestion of carbohydrates will take place, we have to know some fundamental aspects of the carbohydrates. See, actually, if you take the carbohydrate-rich food, that contains the starch and the sugars. The starch which are present in the rice, cereals, etc. And sugars which are present in the milk, cane sugar, honey, and jaggery. So, let us see, what is starch? Starch is a polysaccharide of glucose. It means many monomers of glucose, combined together form the polymer through the bonds called as glycosidic bonds. Many monomers together forms the polysaccharide that is called as a starch. So, again, starch divided into the two type. One is a amylose. Second one is a amylopectin. See, what actually amylose? Amylose is a polysaccharide that is a starch. Here, there is no branches. It means linear polysaccharide. Whereas amylopectin is a polysaccharide, nothing but starch. It contains the branches. So, there is no linear structure. So, monomers of the glucose combined together linearly that forms the amylose. Combined with the another bondings forms the very different forms of the branches. That is called as a amylopectin. Okay, we will see how it looks like. See, there is no branches linear. If you see the structure of glucose, how it looks? This one is the glucose. See, here is oxygen, CH2OH. This one is a carbon 1, this is a carbon 2, this is 3 and 4, 5 and this one is a 6. 6 carbons and the formula is a C6H12O6. OH6. I am not going to draw the H hydrogen OH groups on the glucose. I am just want to say how linear structure of amylose is present. This is the one glucose that contains the 6 carbons. And here it forms a bond that is called as a glycosidic bond. See how it forms the glycosidic bonds. Glucose 1 and glucose 2. Here I mention the 4th carbon. So this one is the 4th carbon. This one is the 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th. If you see the amylose structure that forms the carbon 1 and carbon 4 of the adjacent glucose moiety. So, what type of glycosidic bond here is formed is a alpha 1 to 4 bond. Alpha 1 to 4 bond. So, similarly, here the many glucose moieties like this. It forms the what? That is the amylose, linear structure of the starch. Whereas coming to the amylopectin, there is a linear structure of starch, that is amylose. Amylose connected with the another amylose. Let us see how it looks. Amylose that connect with the another amylose. It forms the bond . See this one is the carbon number 1 2 3 4 5 and 6 . This one is the 6th carbon . This one is the 5th, 4th, 3, 2, 1. Here what actually happened, the bond form in between the this two. So, form the alpha 1 to 6 glycosidic bond. Again, it contains the many number of glucose moieties. And also it contains the many number of glucose moieties like this. It goes in this way, it goes in this way. Due to the formation of alpha 1 to 6 bonds, alpha 1 to 6 glycosidic bond, the amylose that converted into the amylopectin. Amylose that converted into the amylopectin. This is called as entirely what? Starch and starch structure in the form of two types, amylose and amylose pectin, linear structure and also branched structure. So, let us see these sugars. The cane sugar, milk sugar, we know very well milk sugar is a lactate. We know cane sugar is a sucrose. Honey sugar, jaggery sugar also contains the sucrose. Okay, let us see. This is called as a brief introduction and basic points regarding to the carbohydrates, especially starch and sugars. Let us start the how digestion will take place in the digestive tract of the human digestive system. We know very well, the human digestive system started at the mouth. If you take in any type of food, carbohydrate food, that start with the mouth and ends with the anus. In the mouth, there is a gland, salivary glands. Salivary glands. These salivary glands produces the saliva. That saliva contains the alpha amylase enzyme. Alpha amylase enzyme. Actually, what it causes, what it function is the alpha amylase enzyme that act on the starch. We know very well starch is combination of the monomers. Monomers, it forms the two types, amylose and amylopectin. Here is a bond 1-4 alpha glycosidic bond, here 1-6 bond. These monomers, these are the glucose, single glucose moieties. Single glucose moieties that together with the glycosidic bonds forms the what? Amylose and amylopectin. Here amylase is an enzyme which is present in the saliva of human beings. These amylase act on the alpha 1-4. Alpha 1-4 glycosidic bonds. Whenever that act here and act here, act here, that produces the end product of the starch. They call as a maltose. Maltotriose and dextrins. What actually? Maltose is a dimer of glucose. Glucose plus glucose. Whenever there is a glucose and glucose with the single bond, that is a glycosidic bond, that is called as a maltose. Maltotriose is a glucose, glucose, glucose. Whenever there is a two bonds between the three glucoses, that is called as a maltotriose. Whereas dextrins are the more than 8 glucose moieties. More than 8 glucose moieties with the glycosidic bonds, they are called as a dextrin. So, actually alpha amylase is producing the maltose, maltotriose and dextrins whenever they act on the starch. Whenever that act on the starch, alpha amylose, amylase is an enzyme that does not act on the alpha 1-6 glycosidic bond. That should be remembered. So, maltose, maltotriose, dextrins. In the mouth only, the enzyme that is the alpha amylase is present. After the mouth, the food that enter into the esophagus. In the esophagus, there is no digestion of carbohydrates. There is no digestion of carbohydrates because esophagus does not secrete the any enzymes which are act on the carbohydrates. After esophagus, the food enter into the stomach. Actually, in the stomach also, there is no digestion of carbohydrates. There is no digestion of the carbohydrate. Actually, see, in the mouth, amylase mixed with the food. That mix we called as a bolus. Bolus. That bolus that enter into the stomach. In the stomach, that stomach secretes the, some secretions, they include the juices. They called as acids, nothing but hydrochloric acid. Stomach produces the stomach juices that contains the HCl, so acidic in nature. The pH of these juices contains the 2-3. pH of juices of stomach contains the 2, 2, 3. Whereas amylase is an enzyme that active at the pH 6.8. Actually, where it is present, 6.8 pH is a pH, it is present in the mouth region. It is present in the mouth region. The food contains the 6.8 pH. In that pH, alpha amylase is active. This alpha amylase finally enter into the stomach, where stomach that secretes the HCl that produces the pH into the 2 to 3. See, active condition of alpha amylase at 6.8, whenever that reaches the pH of 2 to 3, the active alpha amylase get destroyed or inactivated. So, in the stomach, alpha amylase is inactivated due to the production of the HCl. Okay. So, what happened actually, food, especially carbohydrates, does not digested, but due to the acidic condition, due to the HCl and due to the churning movement of stomach, churning movement of stomach, the food that contains the some cells, plant cells, plus animal cells, get partially digested by the digestion of extracellular matrix. Actually, see, the tissues of animal and the tissues of plant that are present in food get partially digested due to the damage in the extracellular matrix. Extracellular matrix is a matrix that is present in between the cells of the tissues, that is entirely we called as a extracellular matrix. This is the cell, these three are the cells. In between these three cells, there is a matrix that is called as an extracellular matrix. Due to the HCl action and churning mechanism of the stomach, these extracellular matrix get digested. The digested extracellular matrix, which leads to the combination of the HCl. So, such type of food we called as a acid chyme. Acid chyme. So now from the here where stomach, the food that enter next into the duodenum. We know very well, I mentioned in the previous class, duodenum is a site for the mixing of the juices like pancreatic juices and also bile juices. That bile juices and also pancreatic juices that contains the many enzymes and also bicarbonates. Especially pancreatic juices contains the enzymes. Whereas, see here, in the duodenum, acidic chyme get converted into the neutralized by the bicarbonates. Okay. Whereas, the enzymes present in the pancreas like alpha amylase that act on the 1,2,4 glycosidic bonds. So entire the food that is not digested in the alpha amylase of the salivary glands. Most of the food get digested by the alpha amylase in the pancreatic juice of the duodenum. So, alpha amylase that act on the 1 to 4 bonds. Rest of the 1 to 6 bonds also here, that 1 to 6 bonds is digested by the pancreatic alpha glucosidase. Alpha
glucosidase enzyme. Now,
what happened? This food that contains the starch, that starch contains the alpha 1-2 bonds are breakdown by the alpha amylase of saliva and also alpha amylase of the pancreas. At the same time, 1-6 bonds of the starch is digested by the alpha glucosidase enzyme of the pancreas. Now, what it gives the end products here is maltose, maltotriose and dextrose. Here also similarly giving the results as like alpha amylase of the salivary glands. Now, the food that enter from the small intestine duodenum to the rest of the ileum and jejunum. Jejunum and ileum. In the jejunum and ileum, jejunum ileum of small intestine, they produces the enzyme. They produces the enzyme sucrase and also lactase, dextrinases, okay, maltase. See what happened? The food in the form of the maltase, the food in the form of the maltose, and if the food contains the sucrose sugar, and if we take the milk, that milk sugar also present in the food, that is the lactose. Due to the action of the pancreatic and alpha amylase, pancreatic alpha glucosidase and salivary amylase, it produces the maltose and dextrin and maltotriase. Maltotriose. So, all these are degraded by these enzymes which are present in the small intestine. Actually, what this enzyme produces, we will see here. See, sucrose is an enzyme that act on the sucrose that get converted into the glucose plus fructose. Glucose plus fructose. Sucrase is act on the sucrose converted into the glucose and fructose. Lactase is an enzyme act on the lactose of milk sugar. They produces the glucose plus galactose. Glucose plus galactose. Here, dextrinase is an enzyme that acts on the dextrins, which is result by the amylase and alpha glucosidase enzymes. These dextrins that converted into the glucose. And maltase is an enzyme that acts on the maltose. These maltase get converted into the glucose. And maltotriose also enzyme that act on the maltotriose get converted into the glucose moieties. See here, what happened? Here is a polymer, that is a starch. Polymer get converted into the dimers like maltose, trimers like maltotriose and dextrins. And these are digested in the duodenum. And this duodenum also produces the maltose, maltotriose and dextrins. These dimer, trimer and 8 monomers of the dextrins get digested in the small intestine secretions. The small intestine secretions contains the sucrase act on the sucrose that convert into the monomer of glucose and monomer of fructose. These all are the monomers. What we have to remember is దీస్ ఆల్ ఆర్ ది
మోనోమర్స్.
సో ఇన్ దిస్ వే ఫైనల్ ఎండ్ ప్రోడక్ట్ ఆఫ్ ది డైజెషన్ ఆఫ్ కార్బోహైడ్రేట్స్ ఈస్ ఆ మోనోమర్స్. కార్బోహైడ్రేట్స్ ఫైనల్లీ రీచెస్ ఇన్ టు ది మోనోమర్స్. దీస్ మోనోమర్స్ ఈజ్ అబ్జార్బ్డ్ బై ది
స్మాల్ ఇంటెస్టైన్. స్మాల్ ఇంటెస్టైన్ మైక్రోవిల్లై.
సో వాట్ యాక్చువల్లీ అబ్జార్ప్షన్ టేక్స్ ప్లేస్ ఈస్ ఆ మోనోమర్స్ ఆఫ్ ది ఫుడ్, దట్ ఈస్ ఎస్పెషల్లీ కార్బోహైడ్రేట్స్. సో వై డైజెషన్ ఆఫ్ కార్బోహైడ్రేట్స్ షుడ్ బి టేక్స్ ప్లేస్ ఈజ్ the carbohydrates raw material cannot be absorbed by another digestive system, that's why that should be digested in many steps and finally it leads to the monomers. These monomers only absorbed by the digestive system, especially small intestine microvilli, that's why digestion should be takes place in this way. This is a complete structure of carbohydrate digestion. I hope you people understand this concept very clear. So if you like this video and concept, please do subscribe my channel and share to your friends, like and comment. Thank you.